write any message on the live chat which we have here, and I would like to have, like, if you guys can mute yourself so that we can. Sorry, some issues going on with Facebook, like, because I'm connecting this with Facebook Live as well, but it's not working because I can hear my own sound. So I'll just I'll just switch off my Facebook and we'll talk here. We can start our seminar today. This seminar is basically for the scholarship which we are offering to international students, both for online as well as face to face qualification. So we have an agenda for the day today, which is we would like to discuss about the hotel school advantage. I think most of you knows about the hotel school advantage, and but we would like to talk a little bit more on the hotel school advantage, like what exactly happened after COVID and before COVID situation, and how we are different from any other universities and colleges. So that is a very, very important point which we would like to discuss with you guys. We would like to discuss about the programs which we are offering to international students, both for online as well as face-to-face. And then we can talk about the scholarship for the S2 2020 and S3 2020 as well. And then we can take some question and answer as well, which is very, very important. If you have any kind of questions, anything you would like to ask, we can have the questions and answers as well. So can we talk about the industry, like the hotel industry? Now, as you are aware, most of the affected industry which we have at this particular time is the hospitality and tourism industry. It's badly affected around the world. No one is traveling outside their home country. No one is traveling within the country as well. So hospitality industry, especially the hotel industry, has been affected very, very badly. And because of this, we have seen so many jobs has been gone out from all over the world, and people are having some kind of problem while getting some kind of jobs in hotel industry, hospitality industry, in aviation industry. But we know that when we talk about Australia as a whole, the country is opening. The internal border, the state border, is already open, which is a fantastic thing. With this COVID situation, so many restaurants and the hospitality industry has been closed down in Australia. But now it's getting there, and we have seen very less or no COVID cases back in Australia. So things are falling in place, and this is very, very important for this particular industry, because when we talk about Australia, is all touristy country, and they want to open their border, but because it's not because right now Australia doesn't have any kind of COVID cases. New Zealand, they already have zero now, but the main problem which they are facing as compared to other countries is especially India and Nepal, the cases are rising every day, and we have seen so many cases has been gone up in past 10 days, 15 days. So they are, the Australian government is very cautious about that. We have I was the part of one of the webinar which ERI in India did with the Doha Department of Home Affairs, Strait and Australian High Commission. So everybody was there, and we were there, and they have given the presentation that what exactly they're going to do, how the visa going to work. And when we talk about the online situation, how is the situation going to work in favor of the student, how the PSW works, so we can talk about these things as well, because this is quite new for all of us. And I think that's a very, very important point which most of the student is asking from university as well as from the partners. When we talk about the hotel management and tourism industry, the career opportunity and the industry of the future, it's quite good when we talk about Australia. That is a major major supplier of the money from from the hospitality segment. That is after their coal and the other ore sector which they have, I think hospitality stands number two in Australia. And that is why the Australian government is very keen to help all the hospitality tourism sector so that they can back in track and they can get those kind of revenue from this particular industry. And I'm pretty sure that this industry will be back in action very soon. When we talk about the domestic market, it's now moving, and most of the restaurant has been opened, especially in western part of Australia. It's all open, so there is no the schools are it's normal in Western Australia. It's just that Sydney and Melbourne, they are very cautious, and very soon they'll start opening the Sydney as well as Melbourne as well. But when we talk about the offices, agent already opened their offices. The restaurant is back in action. Our Intercontinental Sydney, which is our own property, is going to operate from next week onwards. And that is most of the 5-star and 7-star property is going to be in action very soon from Australia. So the industry of the future of the industry is quite quite good as compared to any other country right now. The career opportunity, when these hotels and restaurants will open, then they would be needing people to work for these restaurants, these hotels, as well as the logistic and supply chain management companies. So the career for hospitality and tourism industry is going to rise very soon back in Australia. When we talk about this particular qualification which we are offering to international students, now most of the students ask what exactly I'm going to do after completion of the program. So there are a lot of career choices which a student has after completion of the program. They can work in event management company, they can work in hotel management company, they can work in hospitality sector, they can work in tourism sector as well. So I would like to tell you one thing very clearly, that we don't prepare any commercial cookery kind of qualification or pedestry kind of qualification, because we are not a commercial cookery kind of hotel school. It's purely a management kind of hotel school which we have, and that's why we offer only management related qualification. So if you see the career choices, most of these students are working in front line of these companies. When you talk about the event management, they are on the front line. Hotel management, they are on the front line. Hospitality, they are on the front line. Tourism, they are on the front line. So they are not working in kitchen department, they are not working, and they are not cooking anything. So a student who would like to work in these sectors in frontline management, then this these qualifications which we are offering is best suited for them. When we talk about who we are, and now this is a very, very important point when I say that why we are different and how we are going to when we talk about MULFA and the hotel school, why we are different with any other university colleges which offer similar kind of program in Australia or outside Australia. So we can talk about that. So when we talk about the hotel school, the we are part of MULFA Group. Now MULFA Group is a very big company back in Australia. It's a $28 billion company. It's not a very small company. So it's a $28 billion company which has colleges which has five star and seven star properties. They are into real estate as well, and they have few other things as well. I'll give you an example that if you can Google, Sanctuary Cove is a resort, it's an island which we have, and it's owned by Mulfa. So complete island is owned by Mulfa, and we have a seven-star property in that particular island. So that island belongs to us. So we are that big. When we talk about hospitality and why we are different, now the main important point which most of the students ask, how my career graph will go after this COVID situation. Now, when we talk about the hotel school, now we are the only hotel school which is owned by a company, which is owned by Mulfa, which is an industry, as well as a public university, which is a Southern Cross University. So this is a collaboration between these two. And when we talk about our students are the safest student if they are doing this particular qualification, because we are from the industry. Now what we have done with all our students is we give scholarship as well as the internship option to each and every student. Now when we talk about the internship option, which is very, very important for bachelor's as well as for the master's team. Now, most of the universities and colleges, they don't have that kind of, the industry expert, we are the industry expert. And when we talk about the internship option for the student, we are giving internship to each and every student in our properties now. So if any student is coming and studying with us, they'll get internship, which is a paid internship with Mulfa properties or our associate properties. When we say this, we proudly say this because we are from the industry and we have those number of hotel chains with us, and that's why we are giving 100% internship to each and every student who are coming and studying with us post COVID as well. So there is no problem if a student is asking how internship going to work. It's exactly same like we were doing before. So there is no change in that. It's just that we are going to offer internship in our properties or our partners' properties. So this is, I don't think any of the universities or colleges are offering this this kind of internship at this particular time, because we are giving 100%, it's a 100% internship to each and every student. And you know it, that we will do it, because all our properties are starting to open from next week onwards. And because of that, we are now needing skilled people who can work with us in frontline management, in backend as well. So we would be needing these kind of students. And that's why we are giving part-time jobs opportunities as well as internship within our properties. I already told you that we are the only hotel school in the world which is owned by a five-star hotel investor, which is a Mulfa, and a public university, which is a Southern Cross University. Now, when we talk about Mulfa properties, now I think most of you have already seen these Mulfa properties. This is Intercontinental Sydney, which is our own property, which is next to the Opera House. This is a Hayman Island. This is what I was talking about. This whole island is owned by us. This is a Sanctuary Cove, which is again in Queensland, and it's intercontinental property. This is Bimbajan, which is again in Queensland. And when we talk about this Selzer property, this is a Merits Hotel, and it's again in Queensland. This is the property which we have in UK, which is Marriott. It's already opened. Sofitel, it's in Paris, is already opened. So it's all working condition. Philippines, this is one of the biggest Sofitel property which any group has. So this is our own Sofitel Manila property. This is Ibis in Hong Kong, and we have properties in other places as well. We have properties in New Zealand as well. So these are the property which is owned by us. So the management of THS and Mulfa is same. So there is nothing when we call that this is owned by any third party or any fourth party. It's not that. These all property is owned by Mulfa Properties, which is the parent company of the THS as well as other companies which we have back in Australia. And that's why I say it very proudly that we are different from any other hospitality provider, colleges or university in the world. We are very different, and that's why we, like, you know, we proudly say that we can give internship as well as the part-time jobs opportunity to each and every student which is going to start with us in this session, next session, and in 2021 as well. Apart from this, when you talk about Southern Cross University, you must be knowing, like, you know, Southern Cross University is a middle-level university. It's not a high-ranked university. But when we talk about like, you know, few of the ranking of this particular university, it's quite there. Like, you know, we are quite highly ranked qualification. So we are number one in Australia for overall international student support. We are 34th in the world for tourism and leisure management education. This is what we are delivering to our students. So number 34 is the, like, you know, it's a ranking of this particular qualification which we are offering to international students. Apart from this, we have, like, a 5-star rating in tourism and hospitality sector, which is number one in education experience. This is our own, like, you know, own ranking, which is only catered to the tourism and hospitality qualification. So we are number one in educational experience, number one in learning resources, in graduate employment and teaching quality as well, which is quite high ranked, 5-star rating which we have. The advantage, like, you know, we already spoke about this, like, but we have few more advantage of the hotel school. So number one is, like, you know, we are the Australia's oldest hotel school. We have started this hotel school in 1989. We started this school in Intercontinental Sydney, and then, like, you know, slowly we've got our different campuses, like, you know, two different campuses, which is in Melbourne as well as in Brisbane. Apart from this, paid internship is a fantastic and the biggest advantage which we have over any other university and colleges. I'm pretty sure that other universities are saying, like, yes, we have paid internship, but they don't have any partners. When we say paid internship, we mean it. We give paid internship to each and every student because we know that we can give them the paid internship within our properties. And this is what we are going to do with our new students as well as existing students. We have unique industry connection because we are from the same industry. We are from the hospitality industry. We are from the hotel industry. We are from the tourism industry. So that's why we have that kind of unique industry connection as well. Apart from this, we have a fantastic location within the CBD. So if you see all the three campuses which we have in Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane, all the campuses are in the middle of the city. So it's like, you know, all the campuses are close to 5-star, 7-star properties where students can go and work part-time as well as full-time. Then we have a global community composed of 35 different nationalities. Yes, most of the university will say that they have a composed, they have community which is more than 100 different nationalities. We have 35. We are happy with that because we don't want, like, you know, heaps of students. We know we need quality of student. That's why we are very, very strict on the quality of student. That's why I think, like, most of you understand and know how we reject the application. So we are, like, we need student, but we need quality student. That is very, very important because we send them to our own property and they, like, you know, sell Mulfa as well after completion of the program. So we are very, very, when we talk about the student, the quality has to be really good. And that's why the community, the nationality is 35. But main important point which we have is that we have Australian students as well. 60% of the students studying in the class is Australian students. So we have a combination of Australian as well as the international students. So unlike any other universities and colleges who can take only international students, this is not the case with us. We can take domestic as well as international students. So this is proper kind of place where you can mingle around with domestic local students as well. And this is very, very important because most of the university, they take only international students. So a student will not be able to understand what exactly the psyche of the Australians. So if you're, like, you know, studying with them, you understand their culture, you understand how they talk, you can understand, like, you know, what exactly they think about this particular qualification. So you'll have an avenue open when you study with the local student, because you'll learn so many different things from the local students. Apart from this, we deliver all public university degree, which is a Southern Cross University, which is our partner university. So we are delivering this qualification with Southern Cross University for past 25 years. So it's a very long association which we have with Southern Cross University. Just an example, that this is the campus which we have. So why we have put this particular slide, because the location which we have is the CBD location. So if you see the hotel school and the Intercontinental Sydney, which is very, very close to each other, and that's why we take our student for live session in Intercontinental if they are in Sydney. Apart from this, these are the 7-star and 5-star property within 1 kilometer of radius where we have the campus in Sydney. So you can see the Opera House is just around the corner, it's just 500 meters away from the campus. So all the restaurants, all the hotels, all the hospitality companies are in this particular area. So finding a job is not that tough, if you are studying with us in the CBD area. And that's why it's very handy for a student who wants to come and study with us in Sydney. And I'm pretty sure that most of the Nepali students, they love to go to Sydney, and that's why they can easily get some kind of jobs, part-time jobs and full-time jobs after completion of the program in the CBD area. When we talk about the Melbourne, again, Melbourne campus is also very close to the Flinders station, which is one of the biggest stations which we have in Melbourne. It's just 6 minutes away from the from Flinders station. When we talk about the properties in the 5-star and 7-star property, it's all there. Crown Casino is it's a different side of it, but yes, it's very, very close to the campus, which is 2 kilometers, hardly 2 kilometers away from the Melbourne campus which we have. So you can see the job opportunities are really very, very high when we talk about the CBD location. That's why it's always good to have a CBD location that student can get jobs in these areas, so they can go and study, and they can go after their studies, they can go for some kind of part-time jobs as well. Similarly, this is a brand new campus which we have, which is Brisbane campus. And if you see the Brisbane campus, again in the CBD area, all the 5-star, 7-star property is 250 meters to 300 meters radius. So again, student can easily find some kind of jobs in this particular campus as well. Apart from this, we do job ready practical training for each and every student. So we take them to our Mulfa properties for field trips. If we have students in Sydney, we take them to Intercontinental Sydney on regular basis. So these are the field trips which we do with all our students, so that they can understand the culture of that 5-star property and 7-star property, how you have to greet your customers and all. So they can get that kind of live experience within the Mulfa property. We take them to our other properties as well. So it's field trips are very, very important for the student, and that's what we do on regular basis with all our students. And last, in March, we have taken our Melbourne campus student to Sanctuary Cove, where they have stayed for 7 days, and they have they enjoyed a lot, because that is one of the best property which we have. And they have learned so many different things in that particular property. I think I've posted that video on the Facebook as well. So if you can go through that Facebook video, it's really nice, and students are enjoying, and they understand that what exactly is required after completion of the program. Apart from this, not just local trips, we do international field trips as well. We take them to Singapore as well, because that is very, very close to the close to Australia. So we take them to Singapore. We have taken few international field trip to UK as well, to Philippines as well, to Hong Kong as well. So because we have our own properties in these areas, in these countries, so we take them for international field trips as well. Apart from this, industry guest speakers series, we have a series of industry guest speakers. So every week we have a industry guest speaker who comes to the campus, who gives face-to-face guest lecture to the student. Right now, because we are online, we're going to start our campus by end of this month. But right now, all the classes are going online. So these industry guest speakers are still going on. Our guest speakers are coming and they're giving their lecture to all the students on regular basis. So it's exactly same like they are taking these kind of guest lectures in their classes in face-to-face manner. But we have those industry guest speakers as well. And it's a series of guest speakers which is going on after July as well. Where the guest speaker will come and they'll share their experience with the student, the real life experience which they have. Apart from this, we have a specialist career coaching for student. We have personal brand development and career panel discussion, which is going on students. And we have mock interview session with our own HR manager, which because we when we talk about these HR managers are from Mulfa Group. So what they do is they work very closely with the student. They give mock interviews and they ask those kind of questions which normally hospitality and hotel sector generally ask from the students. So we have those kind of session with our HR manager with all our students. When we talk about the paid internship, because now we are giving paid internship in our group of hotels. So we have internship which is 26.03 per hour, which we are giving to each and every student. So this is a paid internship for each and every student. So when we talk about the masters and bachelors, we have paid internship for both, 600 hours of paid internship. So a student can roughly earn $15,000 while doing this internship. So it's totally up to the student whether they want to have the paid internship or unpaid internship. But we always ask students to go for paid internship so they can earn some kind of money. When we talk about 26.03, it's quite high when we talk about the normal wage rate in Australia. So 26.03 is quite a decent kind of internship money which we are giving to the students. When we talk about the internship, we have local internship, the internship available within Australia, and we have internship which is outside Australia. So when we talk about the internship, we have overseas internship within our property. So student can go to Paris, student can go to Philippines, student can go to Hong Kong, student can go to London, student can go to New Zealand to complete their internship with our properties as well. But most of the student, master student don't want to go for this kind of internship because they lose the PSW thing. So that's why most of the student from bachelor background, they go for these internships outside Australia. When we talk about last year in 2019, we have sent four students two to UK and I think one to Philippines and one to Hong Kong for internship with our properties. Now, this is the stats which we have for 2019. I'm pretty sure that most of knows these stats, but when we talk about the stats in 2019, we had 10,000 employment opportunity available for our student. So in 2019, we had 925 students. For these 925 students, we have given 10,000 employment opportunities to the student. But these numbers are really, really very, very huge in terms of getting the internship, in terms of getting the part-time jobs, in terms of getting the full-time jobs after completion of the program. So every student roughly getting close to 11 opportunities available in their hand in 2019. In 2020, I'm pretty sure the number will definitely go down, but I'm with our contacts and with our standing in the market, each and every student who's going to complete the qualification with PHS in 2020 will get a job in Australia because we are working toward it, and that's why we are taking these students to our own. The graduate outcome is really very, very high in terms of any universities and colleges in Australia or around the world. 95% of graduate, they get some kind of employment within the 6 months of their graduation. So the numbers are really very, very huge. So 95% of the students, they are getting some kind of job after completion of the program within the 6 months of their graduation period. So these numbers are really very, very strong. 69% of the graduate employment before graduation, they get job. So because we have guest speakers coming to the campus on regular basis, and because of them, they take students from THS, because they like student and they take student from THS. One of the student which we have from Nepal, I'm pretty sure that I'm going to send you a video of this particular student. She's doing fantastic, and THS Mulfa Properties Intercontinental Sydney has already given her job, full-time job after completion of the program. She's in last semester, and before she'll graduate, she'll have full-time job opportunities in her hand. So these are some of the stats, which is fantastic stats for any of the hospitality sector, university or college back in Australia. Apart from this, we have a graduate recruitment service as well. So this is a free graduate placement service which we are giving to each and every student who's going to pass out from the THS, and this is available till 1 year after their graduation. So if a student is not getting any kind of jobs, we will place them and this graduate recruitment service is available for these students till up to 12 months after graduation as well. So this is a fantastic opportunity to for the student. That's why the numbers are really very, very high when we talk about the graduate outcome. 95% of the graduate outcome and 69% of the graduate outcome before completion of the program. So that's why this graduate recruitment service which we have in all three campuses really work very closely with the student, and they place them before 6 months of their completion of the program. So each and every student, if they are smart, if their English is good, they get some kind of jobs in Australia, and that's $26.03 per hour, which is a decent kind of amount for the student. When we talk about the courses offered in admission process, now these are the qualifications which we are offering to international students. So the qualification is Diploma of Hotel Management, then we have Bachelor of Business in Hotel Management, Graduate Certificate of Business in Global Hotel Leadership, then we have Graduate Diploma, and then Master of Business in Global Hotel Leadership. Now, most of the partners will ask this kind of question, that Diploma of Hotel Management is a new qualification. No, it's not a new qualification, it's an old qualification which we are not offering to South Asian student, but because now we are delivering online qualification, yes, student can come and join this Diploma of Hotel Management as online qualification only. So if a student has not been eligible for our bachelor's qualification, they can route this qualification, diploma qualification, to their bachelor's qualification. So they can study Diploma of Hotel Management from their home country, and they'll get 1 year of credit exemption toward their Bachelor of Business in Hotel Management, and then they can fly and they can complete the qualification. So any student who want to come and study with us, and they don't have that kind of grade, their English is not that great, they can come with this Diploma of Hotel Management leading to bachelor's program. Again, the qualification remains 3 years. They'll get 600 hours of internship when they land in Australia. So everything remains the same. It's just that there is a route of diploma, which is an online qualification. Apart from this, graduate certificate was never available for international student, but now we are delivering this qualification because student can complete these 3 units from their home country. And after this, they can go straight for Master of Business in Global Hotel Leadership, and they'll create credit exemption toward the qualification. Now, this is a very, very important point, because I'm pretty sure that most of the partners will ask this kind of question, that why a student will go for the online qualification. If they'll go for this online qualification, they'll not be eligible for PSW, post-study work. Now, I would like to clear one thing with all of you, that a student, as per Australian High Commission, as per the Department of Home Affairs, they say if a student is studying less than 4 subjects from their home country and completing the qualification in Australia, they are eligible for post study work permit. So you can go through their website as well. It's written there. Student, if they are doing two subjects or three subjects, less than four subjects, they are eligible for post study work permit in Australia. So this is a fantastic thing for the student. Like, you know, if they can start with their qualification, they can study three subjects in their from their home country. They'll save their the cost of living, and everything remains the same. Whenever they'll fly to Australia, they'll complete the qualification and they'll be eligible for post study work permit. Means in 1.8 years of their studies, they'll be getting the post study work permit. So there is no problem with that. So any student who wants to start this online qualification, yes, they can start and they'll be eligible for post study work permit. This is the webinar which I attended last week, and they have sent us, which I'm going to send to all of you, they have sent one link which says that student will get the PSW if student has done three subjects from their home country. They'll be eligible for PSW. So this is a very, very important point, because most of the students ask this kind of question, that if I'm going for a master's program, I'll not be eligible for PSW because I'll not be completing 2 years in Australia. No, this is not the case. So they have cleared this thing that student can complete three subjects from their home country. So these are some of the the eligibility criteria, which I am pretty sure that you guys know. Diploma of Hotel Management is again we need a qualification equivalent to an Australian Air 12. And when we talk about the English, it's 5.5, more than less than 5.0. But to enter in this qualification, whether it's an online qualification or face-to-face qualification, student has to complete IELTS. Now, what we are going to do is with online qualification, because we are now delivering the online qualification, we are giving a green signal to Duolingo as well. So student, if they are not been able to get IELTS or PT, Duolingo is an option for this student. So they can get this kind of score, and they are eligible for Diploma of Hotel Management. When we talk about the bachelor's and diploma, what is the difference? The difference is nothing but the grades and the IELTS requirement. That is what exactly a student going to. Diploma of Hotel Management is exactly the year one of bachelor's of hotel management. So there is no difference. It's just that the pathway which we have created for the student who are not eligible for bachelor's program, English wise as well as the grade wise, and that's why we have kept we have started this qualification online. Then we have bachelor, which is a regular bachelor's of business hotel management. So you can see the difference. When we talk about the English language comparable to academic IELTS of 6.0 with no band less than 5.5, as compared to diploma, which was 5.5, no band less than 5.0. Qualification equal to an Australian Year 12 with the required entry grade. In this, you need to have 2.74 CGPA to enter into the qualification. But when we talk about the diploma qualification, it says 2.65. So this is the only difference which we have. Student is going to learn first year of Bachelor of Business in Hotel Management while doing their diploma program. So this is as simple as that. This is the program which we are offering online. Again, 6 months full-time program, four subjects, but we are enrolling only for two subjects at this time, because we understand that student is looking for PSW. So what we are doing is we are giving this graduate certificate of business and global hotel leadership as an online qualification, as an online option to the student, in which first we are going to deliver only two subjects. If a student wants to go for third subject, we can go for third subject, but we insist that student can come to Australia to complete their rest of the studies so they can get the PSW. Now, the entry requirement for this graduate certificate qualification is academic wise, all graduate certificate, graduate diploma and master's is all equivalent. There is no difference academically. But when we talk about the English language, we need 6.0 with no band less than 5.5 to enter into graduate certificate. Or a student can go for Duolingo, which is 105 to 110. In each and every parameters which they have. So if a student can get that, we can give them graduate certificate, which they can start from their home country and then they can fly to Australia for full master's program, which is a face-to-face program. I'm leaving this, and there's a Master of Business in Global Hotel Leadership. If a student wants to go directly for this qualification, still we are delivering this qualification online as well. So if student is eligible, we insist that they can take 2 subjects online and rest 14 subjects while they are in Australia. So by doing this, they'll save some kind of living cost, and they'll complete the qualification in faster mode, and they can get the PSW as well. With this online qualification, they have an option that they can go for Duolingo test as well, which is again a plus point for the student and comparatively quite okay type of examination as compared to IELTS and PT. So Duolingo is not that hard when we talk about the IELTS and PT. Duolingo is, and it's not expensive. You need to pay only $45 to get the Duolingo certification. This is a fee and potential income. I think this is one of my favorite slides. And when we talk about this particular qualification, what exactly the student is going to pay and what exactly the student is going to earn. So this is the fees and potential income which student going to earn after completion of the program or 1 year of their studies. So when we talk about Diploma of Hotel Management, if they are doing the qualification from Australia, they are the indicative fees is 27,600 and the potential earning from internship and casual work is 27,071, which is which is 600 hours of internship plus if they're going to work there, because I'm pretty sure that most of the students they work part-time as well. So we have taken that kind of stats from our existing student that what exactly they're earning while they are doing the qualification and the internship. The base rate is 26.03. So we have calculated this and the balance which they are paying toward their tuition fees. I'm not counting living cost on this, but I'm only counting the fees which they are going to pay. So they are ending up paying close to $528 at the end of their 1 year of qualification. When we talk about the Bachelor of Business in Hotel Management, this is stats which we have taken from our existing students. Please, we haven't done any kind of more data toward other students. It's all our students' data. When we talk about the Bachelor of Business in Hotel Management, the 3 years roughly fees is 82,800. But students are earning somewhere around 73,404.60 in their 3 years of graduation. Means they end up paying close to $10,000. When we talk about graduate certificate, which I don't think will be the case with ours, because we are not going to get any kind of visa. It's just the online program which we are offering. So we will skip that. If a student is doing Masters of Business Global Hotel Leadership, so they are paying $52,000, $53,000 as a tuition fees to us, but they are earning close to $54,000, which include the scholarship, the internship, as well as their casual work. So they are end up earning somewhere around $1,300. So they are in this slide we can easily check that the student can easily earn their tuition fees in Australia, not the living cost. They have to work on that. But when we talk about the tuition fees, they can easily earn, if they are very, very smart, they can easily get this kind of income, which is a potential income for each and every student. And this is a stat which we have taken from our own department with our own students database. Now we have a scholarship option for the student. Now we have scholarship for student commencing in session 2, and then we have session 3 as well. I'm pretty sure that student some student has offer for session 2, and they are thinking of whether they take the qualification or not. But this is a good time to take the qualification, because there are some scholarship which is going on, which is $8,000 of scholarship. This is the first time. I'm working with the hotel school from past 2.5 years, and I'm pretty sure that you guys are also working for so long. We haven't given this kind of scholarship because of the pandemic. We have seen like the student number has gone down in Australia. Like other university, we also need numbers. So this is the three scholarship which is which we are giving to especially to Nepali students, and the available scholarship at 8,000, which is available to only three students. This scholarship is available for all three campuses, it's applicable for all the qualifications which we have. So it's bachelor's and master's qualification. If student wants to go for diploma, a diploma program, graduate certificate program, we have some scholarship for that particular qualification as well, and it's ranging between $4,000 to $6,000. But if they are going straight for bachelor's and master's program, the scholarship is ranging between $8,000, which can be credited to their account when they'll complete the first semester with us. So that is very, very important. Second semester they'll get a credit, so they don't have to pay the second semester fees. It's a one-off incentive which we are giving to the student. And if you need more information, you can email me and you can call me and we can discuss about this scholarship. But I think this scholarship is quite a decent kind of scholarship which we are giving to the student. Yeah. So they are $8,000 scholarship. They'll earn somewhere around $15,000 as a internship. So the potential earning for the student is somewhere around $23,000. Means 1 year fees is free for the student. So you can tell your student that if they want to come and study online as well as face to face in November, we can give this kind of scholarship to the international students. And it's only three scholarships which we have, because we had close to 15 scholarship, but 12 scholarship is already given and student enrolled for the qualification. So we have only left with three scholarship for Nepal student. So this is all about the hotel school and the advantage which we have, and and why we have taken this webinar is there's a simple reason that we would like to tell you that this scholarship is going on. Apart from this, why we are different from any other universities and colleges, and why you can send your kids, your students to us, because the main important point which most of these parents ask and most of the students ask is how I'm going to cope up in this kind of situation. So the situation is very bad for other universities and colleges, but it's not that bad for the hotel school, because we have that kind of resources and we have that kind of standing in the market where we can push our student to get some kind of part-time jobs as well as a full-time job and the internship as well. Because I'm pretty sure that 2020 and 2021 will be very difficult for most of the universities and colleges back in Australia to get internship option for the student. But we have that kind of leverage, and that's why we thought it's a good idea that we can give you some kind of advantage of hotel school. And this is the best advantage which I can think of for any of the student, apart from the scholarship which we are giving to the student. So if you have any kind of question, you can write on chat and we can check. D-Lingo accepted for student visa by immigration? No, D-Lingo is accepted only for the online right now. The Department of Home Affairs is working on D-Lingo. If they can take D-Lingo as a as an alternative for IELTS and PT, I'm pretty sure that they said that they'll come back to us by next week. So we'll give you the complete scenario of D-Lingo. But they are they're working on D-Lingo test as well, because that is very, very easy to take right now, because IELTS PT is very, very tough to get, but D-Lingo is quite easy. So they're working on it. Yes, so totally up to the student. Yes, paid internship is available for each and every student. Bachelor's is compulsory subject. Master's is an optional subject, but most of the students, they take the internship as their qualification. So yes, the internship opportunities is all available for each and every student, and the amount which I have showed you, 26.03, that is the minimum wage rate which we are giving to the student. Some of the students are earning close to $35 as well, and this 26.03 is the minimum which we are giving to the student. any more questions, anything you want to ask? You guys have my my email address and my phone number. I think one of Ashok is writing up students in for online classes since July, but the issue is payment. Any suggestion on this? See, we can work on it. If there is any problem with the with the payment, we can work on it. It's always good if a student can get the offer letter. If you have any kind of student, we can get the offer letter done, and I can take some kind of approval regarding the payment and all. So we can work on that. Because I am pretty sure that Nepal is closed and the financial institution is not working, and it's tough to get the NOC. So we can get a one-off kind of approval from our director. So I can talk to her. GPA for when we talk about the GPA. So to enter into the diploma program, we need 2.65 CGPA. To enter into bachelor's program, we need 2.73 CGPA. To enter into master's program, if you have 3 years degree, we need 3.45 CGPA. If you have 4 years of degree, then we can take some around 3.0 we can take. No worries. So what I'm going to do is, I'm sending PowerPoint presentation to you guys, and we'll send you some more information. If you want to put this on your Facebook or any social media, you can do that. Tag me in if you are friends with me on Facebook, and you need any kind of help, please do email me or call me. I'll write down my email address as well as my phone number, so that I have my details with you, and you can WhatsApp me. How will you be choosing the 3 students for scholarship and criteria? So it's a first come first serve kind of thing. So there is no criteria. They have to be eligible for the program, and if they are eligible for the program, we can offer this scholarship. So it's first come first serve basis. So in this, you don't have to send us any kind of essays or any kind of documentation to get the scholarship. It's you need to send me an email that Ashish, I'm looking for some kind of scholarship and student is this. Send me an email and I'll recommend that student to my admission team. Thanks, guys. Thank you so very much. I'm pretty sure that you guys are taking so many webinars. Sometimes it's very, very frustrating. But thank you so very much for taking this time. And stay safe. And I'll see you guys soon in Nepal. Whenever the border open, I would love to come to Nepal. And we'll meet face to face very, very soon. And if you have any kind of questions, anything you need to ask me about the scholarship program, how it's going to work, please email me, message me, WhatsApp me. You have all my details. So, if you need any kind of support, do let me know and I'll help you out with that. And